Hello, wrestling fans, and welcome to another edition of NCWA, the New Class Wrestling Academy. And we are going to resume the light heavyweight round robin tournament. And now this is the quote-unquote losers portion of the tournament. Both Vinny Lafontaine and Phantagon have only 3 points. And the winner of this match will earn themselves 3 additional points. Earning themselves to be having 6 points. So ladies and gentlemen, let's go down to ringside for the action. Let's not waste a single moment of our time here, fans. I also made a mistake. This is not the losers section. This is actually the continuation of our winners portion of the round robin tournament. Both individuals do have 3 points each. This is now to earn up 3 extra points to tie with Mike Fire, who is in the lead with 6 points. It is a gradual, ladies and gentlemen, it's a gradual thing we're going on here in these round robin tournaments. And here we go! Oof. Off the bat, ladies and gentlemen, 10 seconds in, and already a pile driver, jumping pile driver, beautiful. Choke slam. Oh, on the apron is Vinny Lafontaine. Not much leap there. Oh, going for the same idea there. Study. Oh, that would have been perfect if that low blow was met up. And Phantagon is busted wide open. Look at Vinny showboating. Who does he think he is anyways? Oh, leapfrog. That nasty gash, ladies and gentlemen. More showboating from Vinny Lafontaine. Makes that connection not even a one count. Snapping. Choke slam, hooks the leg, not even a one count as well. Oh. It's amazing how already within less than 3 minutes, Phantagon's already bleeding. Oh, on the apron once more, Vinny Lafontaine. Oh! Phantagon makes that collision.
3, 4, 5.
Look at this.
6.
Oh, onto the barricade.
8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Oh, nice clothesline. That was a stiff one. Oh, right in the twig and Murray. Inside rolling cradle. Pretty even stuff right now, ladies and gentlemen. Oh. Jumping HH pin. This is a great action we're having right now here in the light heavyweight division. Oh, snapping neck break horba. Fanta was way too far for Vinny. Back and forth action, ladies and gentlemen. Ben's gonna go on top. Oh, Fanta blocked that. I didn't think that could be a ding. There you go, make the connection. Vinny now going all the way on top. Three, another block.
Four, five, six, seven.
Full mount. Knuckle sandwiches with no mayo and no mustard.
11, 12.
Well, Fanta still has a good stamina. 5 minutes so far in this match. Whoa! Great action from these two. Single leg Boston Crab, but a reach for the ropes. Oh! Vinny! Vinny Lafontaine! Jumping HH pin! 6 minutes already on the clock. Back to the full mount. Punches on that bloodied mask. Back scratcher. More posing. Ah. Oh my goodness.
One, two, three.
Oh, diving headbutt to the top floor. Sharp shooter on the outside floor.
15,
17, 18. Samoan drop. That was well calculated, fans. Almost a count of three. 7.5 minutes, by the way. Great action we're seeing here tonight, fans. Scoop slam once again with those knuckle sandwiches. Phantagon has to come up with something clever to escape, otherwise his face is gonna get severely smashed. Oh, big lariat. Oh, rear naked choke. Looks like Fanta's gonna be a goner anytime soon here, fans. Oh. Beautiful clothesline. Oh, the rope, of course. Oh, the Corona. Great counter. Oh. Scoop pile driver. Oh, misses the clothesline. Great wrestling from these two, I'm telling ya. Oh, it's all inside rolling cradle once again, no count. Remember, 15 minute time limit bouts. Especially for those who are in singles competition. Will he have enough time? Oh, he connects it. More showboating. Oh no, out of the barricade.
12.
Come on, Vinny, shake the cobwebs. Could this be? Not enough. 10 minutes, fans. 10 and a half minutes. Yeah, Fanta is on the verge of getting a special here, fans. Flying and scissors takedown. Poke him in the chops. Another Hurricanrana. And there goes Fanta's opportunity for a special. Oh, judo takedown once more. Oh. Match, fans. Single leg Boston Crab, but Vinny reaches the ropes. Oh! How is Fanta getting up with all these maneuvers? 12 minutes, ladies and gentlemen, into this. And there's the helicopter pin. Oh! Two count only, wow! Ladies and gentlemen, I am impressed with this man. Don't think you've won yet there, Vinny. Back on that submission. And that's it! Vinny Lafontaine wins by way of submission, ladies and gentlemen, in 12 minutes and 38 seconds. And it looked as if that was the goal. That was Vinny Lafontaine's goal, but you saw the bloody Phantagon performing that helicopter pin, and yet it didn't do the job. It got a two count. Somehow, some way, Vinny was able to survive the clutches of Team Mexico's Phantagon. And this is the closing moments. That rear naked choke. There's the tap out. It's all said and done, ladies and gentlemen. For 3 points. 3 extra points at this point. Vinny earns himself 6 points and now is tied with Mike Fire. Good job on both superstars in the light heavyweight round robin tournament. And this tournament is still, there's lots more to go, fans. A whole lot more in each of the round robin tournaments. So stay with us. A whole lot more action here on NCWA. And coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, here in the women's round robin tournament, this is now the quote-unquote losers portion of the tournament. Both Cassandra and Carolina Rodriguez have 0 points. So the winner of this match will earn themselves 3 points. Let's go down to ringside for the action. Before we go on to this contest, I'd like to say thank you each and every one of you for supporting the Loud and Clear Pictures YouTube channel. Please subscribe if you're brand spanking new. Don't forget to click on notifications so you do not get to skip or miss anything, miss a match, miss a moment, what have you. Click like. Please post your comments below. We want to hear more from you. We want to know what you like best. You want to know what you like least. Your voice needs to be heard. You want to get your voices heard? This is the channel for it. So please, before you go on about your business, subscribe, click like, and hope that you guys get to enjoy more New Class Wrestling Academy. This is where stars are born. This is where wrestlers for fantasy pro wrestling come to life. This is the starting ground. This is the foundation. This is the building block to become a major superstar in fantasy pro wrestling. This is the place. I also want to say tremendous work between Vinny Lafontaine and Phantagon. That was a very beautiful match. I actually recall In 2020-2021, both Vinny and Fanta had a match. And I believe it was for the Hardcore Championship. Fanta won that one. And Fanta was, like, amazing. Fanta was unstoppable. I mean, he was on an undefeated streak. And now look what happened 3 years later. 2024, we're now... Oh, nice sunset flip. Now we saw an incredible match between those two. Fanta had more special opportunities than Vinny did, and yet Vinny was able to secure a victory via submission. And I'm looking forward to having Mike Fire and Vinny Lafontaine in singles action. One will have to lose. That's what I find so captivating about these tournaments. Is that everyone gets to wrestle everybody? Yes. But once the points start to rack up, you're going to get two guys who are like undefeated, you know, and one's going to have to lose. It's that who's going to lose, you know, who's going to advance and who's going to lose, who's going to be left behind with the remaining points. Well, now in the women's division, oh, Cassandra sending Carolina Rodriguez on the outside floor. Both of them have 0 points. So now we know there will be a winner. One will get 3 points. Oh, nice dragon screw. Nice monkey flip there by Cassandra. Cassandra, who has been in this business before, signed in for FPW in 2002, like late 2002. competed from 03 to 06 in the beginning, and then took a year off, came back as a member of the Rejects, the Notorious Rejects. And if you think about it, ladies and gentlemen, Cassandra was part of something revolutionary. Because I even remember in the WWE in 2010, when the whole NXT was created and the Nexus group, a band of young upstarts who are trying to take over WWE. That was a cool idea. But the thing is that Fantasy Pro Wrestling created that 2 years prior. Hootie-Corona, ladies and gentlemen, from Cassandra and no. Carolina kicks out. And Cassandra, like I said, was part of that revolution. She, Lawless, and Perfection, formerly known as Darkstar, those three created that. They created the Rejects, a whole band of individuals who had careers in fantasy pro wrestling, made a return to get revenge on the management. And did they ever receive such incredible pop? Even though that lasted for about a year, two count, it still made a major difference. And Cassandra, to me, in my eyes, she will always be remembered as that, the only woman who revolutionized that idea to get revenge on management for how they were treated and how they were exposed. They had all that attention, and then all of a sudden, this one day, they're gone, and no backlash, nothing, no repercussions of any kind. Look at that. Cassandra has been in the academy since 2020, and she's been doing a fantastic job as far as I know. I mean, look how agile she is. Look at the flexibility. We saw a senton backsplash, a moonsault. And Carolina was doing so good at one point, I thought that she was going to score a victory. Actually, no. Cassandra was on the verge of actually winning. But Carolina has an opportunity to get back on track here. Almost 6 minutes into this matchup, ladies and gentlemen. Beautiful snap suplex. Cassandra, former women's champion. It'd be interesting to see if she goes back to fantasy pro wrestling like on a full-time basis. That would make her third return, and I think she would be the only female in fantasy pro wrestling to make a return for the second time. Because when you debut, that's your first time. When you make a return, that's a first return. And when you come back another time, that's a second return. So there's no. So I made a mistake. It's not a third return. It's a second return. But it's as if to say you came back for the third time. So you have your debut, then you have your return, then you have a second return. So it would be Cassandra's second return if she gets signed back on again. But I don't know if that's gonna happen. There's always a place for everybody in the world of professional wrestling. I mean, Cassandra may have had a return, and it may not have been the best in the world because she wasn't liked. She was very hated. Being part of that hated Rejects team, you know, it's not going to spark much interest, if you know what I mean. Well, Carolina, though, is getting back on track here. A sleeper hold brings her down into a full mounted punches. Look at that. Cassandra now is getting closer to the teal colorization. Oh, beautiful bridge German suplex. Try and top that one, ladies. Very simple sleeper hold that can put anyone out. You can get many victories from a sleeper hold. But Cassandra, being a part of the Academy, it's a whole different ball game now. It's a whole different era of wrestling. At this point, it's not really about factions. It's about improving yourself and becoming a better version of who you want to be. You want to be hated? Be hated. But the important part is the craft. And Cassandra never got a chance to be a part of the N64 platform, and here she is. Oh, reverse Death Valley driver, followed by a Mexican surfboard stretch. Nine minutes have passed, ladies and gentlemen. Oh. This match is pretty even. Belly to back, overhead suplex by Carolina. We're seeing a really good match between these two. They both want to win. That's the thing about this, is that they both want to win. Oh, that was excellent. DDT. Carolina is getting herself back on track. Oh, the kitchen sink. That was very sneaky. Shoryuken. 10 minutes have lapsed. 5 minutes remaining on the clock. Come on, ladies, execute your moves. It's a very even match. It's hard to decide who's actually going to walk away victorious. At this point now, it's a very crucial moment. They each have 5 minutes remaining on the clock, which means they have about 2.5 minutes to really start to make their moves, really start executing those strong grapples, those strong strikes. Look at that. That's a strong grapple right there. And look at Carolina's stamina now. It's really made a huge difference. European uppercut in there. She's wailing her arms. She's got the special. Strong grapple, super kick, beautifully done, but reaches the ropes. And that's a big mistake, a part of this rook, Carolina Rodriguez. If that super kick was executed away from the ring ropes, it would have been a different ball game. Single leg Boston Crab. Will we get a second submission hole, a submission victory? Once again, Cassandra reached for the ropes. And now Cassandra has to go back to the basics. Weak holds, weak strikes. To get that teal away and get back to the yellow, the green, the red. Oh, flying head scissors takedown. This could be Cassandra's comeback. Oh, going for that reversed Death Valley driver, I presume, going back to the lockup. Double underhook DDT with nowhere to run. And now that's smart. Carolina drags her opponent to the center of the ring, turns her over, goes for the cover. One, two, and there's the three. Carolina executes that double underhook DDT, and it was all over. And that wasn't even her finishing maneuver. Well, we don't need to actually necessarily see what happens here. We know that it was a double underhook DDT. She dragged her opponent, so Carolina actually understood. She really knew what she had to do. Otherwise, it would have been a rope break, and the match may have not ended. Because look at the time. 12 minutes, 15 seconds. Each of them had only almost 3 more minutes remaining. Otherwise, it would have been a draw game. And once again, both have no victory. No points. So Carolina Rodriguez scores three points in the tournament standing, and Cassandra still at zero. We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen, with more wrestling action still to come on the heavyweight division. We got Levar, Winslow, and Josh Hennessy. But we've got the tag team round robin tournament, and it's going to get spicy, ladies and gentlemen. Don't go anywhere. More action on NCWA. And coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, Team Aki. That's Aki Man and Aki Woman on the left side. On the right side, it's Juancho Gonzales and Hector Ramirez, the Latin American Express. I keep getting that damn heart attack that I have lost all my data. I hate that about WWF No Mercy. For those of you, I mentioned this and I'll keep mentioning it, I'll keep reminding. But it's that fear of losing your data. That song is the default theme song your creative character has. And I keep thinking it's gonna happen one day where I'm gonna lose all my data. So Team AKI, or Aki, or Aki, however it's pronounced, set for battle. They have no wins and no losses. In fact, the last time we saw both Aki Man and Aki Woman in the ring, it was a time limit draw. I'm hoping that we don't get the same results this time around in this matchup here. Hector Ramirez has a bit of Latino eat. As I mentioned, this is going to be a very spicy match. Latin American Express. Juancho Gonzalez and Hector Ramirez, who is a lot, who reminds me a lot of the late, great Eddie Guerrero. Well, now, here we are, ladies and gentlemen, our tag team contest. As mentioned, Aki Man, Aki Woman have no wins and no losses, only one draw. A 30-minute time limit had expired. It's a shame, but these things do happen, especially in tournaments. I remember the infamous WrestleMania 4 pay-per-view event, where it was a 16-man tournament and we had like a couple of buys or no contests or the time limit expired kind of thing. And that was like, to me, that was normal. In large tournaments, it was bound to happen. Now, we see a lot of tournaments where we don't get to see a whole lot of buys. I know one King of the Ring tournament, I know for sure there was a draw or a buy. And I'm sure it was all inspired by the WrestleMania 4 tournament. So, little fun facts, you know what I mean? Little fun facts. Great job by Karina and Cassandra. Very surprised, by the way. Very, very surprised that Carolina was able to pick up a victory against a veteran like Cassandra, who's been technically in this business for over 20 years, but she has been away from the ring for so long because, again, she debuted or she signed with FPW in 2002, had her first official match in 2003, and then she stopped in late 06 to come back in 08, and after 2008 she was gone, never to be seen, never to be heard of until 2020. So it's a big deal, a big gap, a 12-year gap. But she's been competing in the academy for the last 4 years. So she's getting herself back on track here. I think she's been in the company for just as long as she was the first time around. So past her debut and her return. So, for those of you who are confused, Hector is the one that's in the ring right now with Aki Woman, and Juancho Gonzales is the one that has blood all over his chest. Flying head scissors takedown. Look at that. You see how both partners just leaped into the ring like that? Ready for action. Ready for a good match. Hell, I've been stoked since the first match of this evening. Still haven't gotten over Phantagon and Vinny Lafontaine. Beautiful pendulum backbreaker. Oh, nice snapmare. To the turnbuckle. I was hoping for some top rope Frankensteiner action. We've been seeing a lot of smaller athletes competing. I'm looking forward to our heavyweight division, Josh Hennessy and Levar Winslow, former NCWA world champion. Very proud of that man, how he's been part of the academy since we've really introduced it to an audience, because the academy's been around since 2010, right? We've been in there before, but I want to remind the audience, especially for those who are brand new. And LeVar has come a long way since then, making himself into the main roster in 2022, winning the world championship by defeating the longest reigning world champion or heavyweight champion, Keegan Yamada. And Keegan is still deemed, actually no, Keegan lost. Keegan is not even the title holder. If you have been tuning in, Ryan Rage is the one that actually won the match, but it was thanks in part of a double team with Keegan. Keegan did a lot of the work. In fact, Keegan did all the work. He was the one that executed that 3-1/4 neck breaker. You know, seeing LeVar Winslow in the air like that and then using that move, Ryan Rage just seized the opportunity, took advantage of that, and went for the pin and got the 3 count. He's got the W, he's got the belt now. He's the champion, he's the title holder. It's incredible. Oh, machine gun chops there by Aki Man. Look at them. Aki Man and Woman. They both have their t-shirts on. Sporting. Oh, wow. Sporting the company name. The AKI brand. Fantasy Pro Wrestling has their shows in the THQ Stadium or the THQ Arena. Well, that's where it all goes through, you know? Oh, going for a snap suplex, but failed as Juancho held on. What? Oh! That would have been a perfectly awesome drop kick, but... Oh! Both of them collide, and a low blow! Nicely done there by Juancho. Great athleticism from these guys, I'm telling ya. Oh, inverted atomic drop. That was a cool catch. That was really nice. Running bulldog. Yeah, Juancho's gonna need to have that mask removed as there's blood seeping, kind of like Phantagon in the early match there. Like, you're bleeding through the mask. I mean, there's gonna be a definite blockage. Oh wow, that dropkick sends Akiwoma to the outside floor. Oh, that would have been cool either way. Akiman was pretty much doomed. No. This action is getting out of control, ladies and gentlemen. And it's interesting to see men and women wrestle against each other. We don't get to see that. We don't see that at all in, like, even in AEW. We don't see that. And it's unfortunate because I'm a firm believer that men and women can wrestle against one another. I mean, who says that you can't do that? Why can't a woman and a man wrestle each other? You know? Nice snapmare. Hector Ramirez. Oh, Akiwoman resisted. Oh, look at this! There's that three-quarter net breaker we were talking about there. That's what got Ryan Rage to win the heavyweight championship belt. Oh! 10.5 minutes have lapsed, ladies and gentlemen. You're seeing a great wrestling match tonight. Oh, shoulder breaker. All this, ladies and gentlemen, for 3 points. Neither team have any points at all. This is another quote-unquote losers section of the tournament. In my view, there aren't any losers. The only losers are those who have quit for selfish or ridiculous reasons. Mostly due to, like, hatred or weird, funky drama or whatnot. But in this case here, everyone's a winner. Oh, look at this, a rolling leg bar! Good position there by Akiman. Waistlock. That beautiful jumping kick there. That jumping back kick. Oh! Aki woman getting herself involved here. She gets tagged. Snap suplex. Oh, well, she's got no, she has no grapefruits, if you know what I'm talking about. Oh, double team arm drag. Great teamwork by the Latin American Express. to the turnbuckle. Come on, I want to see some top rope Frankensteiner action here. Machine gun chops. A la Eddie Kingston. Who I'm sure that Eddie got it from somebody else, but I can't remember at this point. Oh. Both Aki Woman and Hector got immediate contact from that, and now Aki Woman on the outside floor. Oh, missed that hook kick. Oh, double underhook DDT was countered by a release Northern Lights suplex. 13 and a half minutes have gone by, and Aki Woman is in the blue. Hector is now slowly building his stamina for possibly his big move. Oh, my. Tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. Yeah, get out of there, Aki Woman. Great wrestling, man. Great back and forth action. That's exactly what I was looking for, ladies and gentlemen. Oh! Failure to communicate there on that one. Off the ropes goes Juancho and back body drop. Block after block, counter after counter with these two. Flying head scissors, takedown. 15 minutes have gone by. 15 minutes remaining. Jumping pile driver. Juancho. Very agile, very athletic. He reminds me of a Rey Mysterio Jr., if you think about it. It's like Hector reminds me of Eddie Guerrero, and Juancho reminds me a little bit of a Rey Mysterio. Great wrestling from these guys, man. I'm telling you, this is the most, like, for its time, for the time of this, this is one of the most entertaining and more interactive video games I can think of. And even if we are at 2024, this game is still timeless. Sidewalk slam. Oh, on the ropes. Good job. Aki Woman was in the blue. Now she's back on track here. I guess that tag gave her all that tagging out really gave her a perspective of things. More machine gun chops. Look at that. Off the ropes. Whoa, what? Knocking two birds with one stone. Good job, Aki Woman. Oh, snap suplex. That's the thing about tag teams, is that your partner will be on the apron and he or she can grab you and do whatever you want, making it almost like a two-on-one disadvantage. (Clears throat) series of heavy strikes from both teams. Haven't seen anybody counter from that head scissors. And it's a version of a head scissors takedown too. Hector in a rough space there, off the ropes. Oh! Don't attack your partner like that, dude. Like, so it's, she's just a woman, though. Also getting colliding with the announce table. Shoulder breaker. That's also a weak grapple move, but it's an effective move. Off the ropes, back body drop. God dang. Off the ropes. Oh, very strange body press, but it still connects. Nice block. Machine gun chops. Oh, diving DDT, but Juancho gets right back up. I think that Acumen's gonna go for a tag. Maybe, maybe not. It all depends. Yeah, he's gonna tag out. Setting up Acuwoman for more punishment here. Waist lock, back suplex, almost like a neck suplex. Boom with the cover. One, two, and that's it. That's it. That's all, ladies and gentlemen. That back suplex. Do we have it? Oh, I was hoping that we were gonna get a shot of that, but there's no shot of that back suplex. Almost like a neck drop or a neck suplex too. But at the end of the D, Acuwoman gets the pin, but with also help. She had received help from her partner and Acuman. Good job. With 19 minutes and 40 seconds, Team AKI or Team Aki defeats Juancho and Hector, the Latin American Express. That means that Acuwoman and Acuman both have, the team itself have 3 points in the tournament standings, while Latin American Express sadly still have no points. But that's okay. There's still plenty more matches left that they have on their in the round robin tournament. Surely they will pick up the pace. Now on to our main event, fans. Stay with us. All right, ladies and gentlemen, for 3 points, Josh Hennessy takes on Levar Winslow as part of the heavyweight round robin tournament. Let's go down to ringside for the action. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Don't forget to click on the notifications so you do not miss a match. Click like, post your comments down below. Tell me what you think. What do you like best? What do you like least about our programs? We want to hear from you, the viewers, the fans who enjoy CAW. And here we go. Josh Hennessy, Levar Winslow. Oh! Standing slightly over the apron now. A club to the chest. One, Oh! Josh Hennessy now taking advantage. Oh, blocked. How the hell can you block a freaking heavy man off of the top rope like that? Oh, open hand palm strike. Very unique way to start things off here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, here in this main event. Where did he go? Oh, that's gonna be a hip toss, I think. Josh Hennessy was prepared for a hip toss. Snap suplex. Don't turn around. Off the ropes. Wait a minute. Oh, beautiful power slam. Wow. Big man like Josh Hennessy doing moves like this. Beautiful power slam. Nice snap suplex. Finding the mark. Beautiful power slam once more. Oh! Oh, oh boy, that was a shoulder blade on the corner. That edge of that barricade. How did that slap not even connect? That made no sense. Irish whip. Hip toss. There you go. Leapfrog. Josh Hennessy is in the teal. No, blocked the leg. Inverted atomic drop. Oh my goodness. Oh! Standing sidekick. And a strike. Sending Josh Hennessy all over to the outside floor. Remember, there are disqualifications and there are countouts. Oh! Yeah, now Hennessy is definitely in the blue. Almost in the danger zone. He's gonna be in the la. Oh, nice escape. There's the danger. Hennessy needs to get himself back on track again if he wants to win this thing. Oh, but the long legs reach the ropes. That's actually pretty good. 5 minutes have lapsed, ladies and gentlemen, in this match. And come on. Manages to get that Countered power slam. Excellently done. Oh. 6 minutes have passed. Schoolboy, nice. Ah, oh, not even a one count. Great wrestling from these guys, I'm telling you. Look at this. Oh, beautiful leg drop. A page out of The Godfather. Oh, Irish whip. Oh. Single leg Boston Crab. Very effective maneuver. I think Josh is getting himself back on track here. Running the ropes here. Really trying to exhaust Levar Winslow. Oh! Oh, rear naked choke. Oh, I honestly thought that was it. This match continues. Spinning backdrop. More showboating from Levar. There you go. What a match, what a night, ladies and gentlemen, it has been. Eight minutes have elapsed. It is really a showcase showdown. Oh, snap suplex. From a big man like Josh. Incredible. And Levar stops it. Beautiful release, German suplex. How is this even possible? Oh, running DDT. That was excellently executed. What a move. Falcon arrow, but again, the long legs of Josh. Sleeper. Very effective maneuver. And that can do some wonders. Oh. Single leg Boston Crab once more. Away from the ring ropes. Is Josh trying to get a submission victory? Oh, snap suplex once again. Woo-wee. Oh. Levar is getting some moves around here. Oh, for Pete's sake. Oh, Tombstone Ball Driver. Ten minutes have elapsed, ladies and gentlemen. Oh! What's your move? I don't believe it. Schoolboy! Only a two. Wow. Gets him. Rope break. Josh has been in the teal almost the entire match. Oh! Oh, sitting on the outside floor! Oh, vaulting body press. Oh, the STF! Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide for Josh Hennessy, but he is not forfeiting, he is not giving up. 10, 11, 12, look at this.
13,
14, 15. Unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. Flying head scissors from a big man like Josh. Desperation move. Cross arm breaker. Oh, wow, man. Josh wants to win this. You can see it, too. With these submission holds, cross arm breakers, camel clutches. Look at this. Single leg Boston Crab. And the crowd's going nuts here, fans. This is great. Oh. Couple of knee strikes here. Levar now is in the teal. Look at this. Oh, damaging the knee. More knee strikes. Levar, fans, is in dire effing straits. Oh, look at that rear naked choke. Now Josh Hennessy going on the top floor. Oh, misses the elbow drop. The flying of the Macho Man elbow drop. Oh. Machine gun chops. Hey, why not, eh? And he reached, and Hennessy reaches for the ropes. 1 minute remaining, fans. 1 minute remaining. Too close to the ring ropes. Too close. Too close. Oh my goodness. And look at Levar. Oh. Seconds remaining on the clock. Reaches the ropes. This is really, really pushing it, fans. Hennessy wants to win this match so bad. With 10 seconds remaining on the clock. Can this be in it? Can this be it? Oh! Oh no! A time limit draw. Look at Levar's leg. The 15-minute time limit mark has reached. And both men suffer a draw game. Honestly, if it were up to me, I'd say let them have this match continue. But maybe once the round robin tournaments are all over and done, we can have a rematch down the road. Hennessy, unfortunately, and Levar both did not score a victory. This was a very, very tough battle, fans, but it is what it is. Thank you very much for tuning in. Thank you very much for watching our program. We'll see you next time here on NCWA, that's the New Class Wrestling Academy. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Don't forget to click on the notifications so you do not miss a match. Click like and leave a comment down below.